God lives and works today, and nothing brings him more joy than to find people who are willing to really follow Jesus. What does it mean to follow on the way of Jesus in everyday life? The answer is in today's meditation by Basileia Schlink called Choose Jesus' Way.
When did Jesus receive the greatest power of authority? When he was arrested in Gethsemane and committed himself to being powerless. His hands were bound, and he couldn't work at all. Yet, with his hands nailed to the cross, he accomplished the greatest deed of all time. On the cross, he accomplished our redemption. When Jesus was arrested, his disciples lost their confidence in him. Jesus had told them on the way to the Garden of Gethsemane that they would all fall away. Why? Because he did not act as they thought he would, in power and glory, but rather in weakness and powerlessness.
We too experience this. We ask Jesus to prove his power in our sickness, in financial or family problems, in emotional conflicts and temptations. Yet Jesus seems to be powerless. It seems as though his hands are bound. He is silent when we cry, "Show us your power, Lord Jesus Christ." It is just the same as it was at the arrest. There he did not speak the word of power that would have made the earth open and swallow up the soldiers. Yet the hours of his passion were hours laden with the greatest power, power to redeem the whole world. Love that endures, suffering and silence, has power over all things. But this power will only be revealed in his time.
When Jesus seems to be powerless, when his hands seem to be bound and he doesn't come to help us, he has a very special purpose. He is entreating us, "Do not lose your confidence in me now. Show me your trust and faithfulness. When I don't come to help you immediately, and you do not understand me, have faith in me. Expect me to bring you the help and the solution that you need. Trust that this delay is necessary in order that I might accomplish more for you than if I had answered immediately. Expect something special in this situation."
Strength arises out of weakness, light out of darkness, a glorious victory and resurrection out of defeat and apparent loss. But who believes this? Who trusts Jesus when he seems to be bound with chains? Jesus is looking for souls who will not lose confidence in him when he veils his power. He longs for souls who will trust that he will reveal his power in his time. He waits for those who will believe that in the end, the answer will be even more wonderful than that which they had expected. Jesus is seeking disciples who will go the way of suffering and endurance, in the knowledge that glory comes from suffering and victory from apparent loss.
Jesus went the way of the Lamb, enduring everything in silence. But this way of chains has become a majestic way, because it was taken by the King of all kings. Jesus will also bring victory out of defeat for all who will go this way with him. Here on earth they will have great power, and above they will be seated on thrones.
Let me, Lord, go along with you, both joy and sorrow share with you, close at your side forever.
You have been listening to a program written by Basileia Schlink of the Little Land of Canaan. To learn more about how God lives and works today, visit us at our website, www.canaan.org. That's K-A-N-A-A-N.org. If you contact us, we would be happy to send you a free inspirational booklet. If you do not have access to the web, please contact this radio station for our postal address. God bless you.